BGMC. The biblical truth lives here.
The ancient Hebrew scriptures foretold of the Anointed One, Yeshua HaMashiach. The Messiah Yeshua came to call the people back to the truth of His word and to follow that righteous path. Yeshua then called Jewish men to be His disciples, and after His death and resurrection, those Jewish men told the world about the Jewish Messiah. Now, after 2,000 years, Beth Goyim Messianic Congregation has that same calling of those Jewish men, telling all people, both Jew and Gentile, about the proper ancient path, teaching the Route 66 King's Highway from Genesis through to Revelation, and how you need and can get back to the proper roots of the faith and a closer walk with God. Now, let's hear the message.
Let's go get a blessing. All right, we're going to be doing Sukkot Intermediate Level, Part 2.
Vamos a estar estudiando Sukkot nivel intermediario, parte número 2.
Last week we went over a lot of the Brit Hadashah readings and New Testament readings.
La última semana repasamos muchas lecturas del Nuevo Testamento.
So we'll probably have three more parts to Sukkot.
Tal vez va a haber tres partes más para el estudio de Sukkot.
Because we have 48 slides to get through tonight, and I don't think that will happen.
Porque tenemos 48 páginas para estudiar esta noche, y no creo que eso va a suceder.
So going on to slide number 2.
So ahora en la página número 2.
We're going to go over a quick overview of last week's class.
Vamos a repasar ligeramente de la clase de la semana pasada.
So if you're turning, next slide, turning your Bibles to Matthew 22.
Abran sus Biblias a Mateo capítulo 22.
Matthew 22 verse 11 and 12. This is just review.
Mateo capítulo 22 versos 11 y 12. Esto es solamente un repaso.
Did you call Rav Will, Tristan? Matthew 22 verse 11 and 12.
Mateo capítulo 22 versículos 11 y 12.
Matthew 22 verse 11 and 12. This is just review, so we're not going to go over it full.
Mateo capítulo 22 versículos 11 y 12, esto es solamente un repaso.
Now when the king came in to look at the guests, he saw there a man who wasn't dressed for a wedding. So he asked him, "Friend, how did you get in here without wedding clothes?" The man was speechless. So as we were reading last week,
como estuvimos leyendo la semana pasada,
and discussing that Sukkot is the wedding feast.
Resumiendo que Sukkot es la fiesta matrimonial.
It's about a time with being at the Lord's table.
Es un tiempo cuando estamos en la mesa del Señor.
Not the table here,
no la mesa aquí,
but the table up in heaven.
Pero la mesa allá arriba en el cielo.
Because also references Matthew scripture.
Porque esta es una referencia aquí también en el en la escritura de Mateo.
Is Matthew 7, verse 23.
Es Mateo capítulo 7, versículo 23.
Where the Lord's going to say to your face, "I don't know you."
Donde el Señor te va a decir a la cara, "No te conozco."
And one of the keys is that you're not wearing the wedding clothes that you're supposed to be wearing. Dayan, could you mute, please?
All right. Sorry.
Thank you.
Okay. Now, say that again.
Okay. That Yeshua is going to tell you to your face that you don't have your wedding clothes on.
Yeshua te va a decir a la cara que no tienes la ropa de boda puesta.
So in Matthew 7, verse 23,
so en Mateo capítulo 7, versículo 23,
Yeshua says, "Get away from me, you worker of lawlessness."
Yeshua te va a decir, le va a decir, "Apártate de mí, hacedores de iniquidad."
And you're at the wedding because you are lawful people.
Y estás en la boda porque son gente de de la ley, de la ley.
But then the king's going to tell you to your face,
pero entonces el rey te va a decir a la cara,
"Get out of my wedding."
Sálgase de mi boda.
And because you're not dressed properly.
Porque no están vestido apropiadamente.
Going on to the next slide, turn to Revelation 7.
Vamos a la próxima página y abrimos nuestra Biblia a Apocalipsis capítulo 7.
Revelation 7 verse 9.
Apocalipsis capítulo 7 versículo 9.
As I said, this is just review. We went over two hours last week.
Esto es solamente un repaso. Nosotros estudiamos más de dos horas la semana pasada.
Revelation 7 verse 9.
Ahora Apocalipsis capítulo 7 versículo 9.
How do you know the king is going to give you the wedding clothes?
¿Cómo sabes que el rey te va a dar la ropa de boda?
Is through Revelation 7 verse 9.
Es a través de Apocalipsis capítulo 7 versículo 9.
After this, I looked, and there before me was a huge crowd, too large for anyone to count, from every nation, tribe, people, and language. They were standing in front of the throne. They were standing in front of the throne and in front of the Lamb, dressed in white robes and holding palm branches. Okay, two references to Sukkot.
Hay dos referencias a Sukkot.
Okay. One, we speak about the white robes again.
Hablamos sobre las batas blancas de nuevo.
And that is a reference from what we just read in the Matthew scripture.
Y eso es una referencia de lo que terminamos leer en la escritura de Mateo.
Who's going to give them the robes?
¿Quién le va a dar las batas?
The Father in heaven is going to give the robes.
El Padre en el cielo le va a dar las batas.
So when he comes to inspect you,
so cuando él viene a inspeccionarte,
and you don't want to put on that robe of righteousness,
y no quiere ponerte esa bata de justicia,
then he's not going to let you in to his house.
Entonces él no te va a dejar entrar en su casa.
Or even if you are there, he's going to kick you out.
Y si estás ahí, él te va a sacar.
Because he wants to tell you to your face, I don't know you.
Porque él te va a decir a tu cara, no te conozco.
Then the other part of Revelation 7, verse 9,
y la otra parte de Apocalipsis, capítulo 7, versículo 9,
that references Sukkot,
que es referencia a Sukkot,
is that they're holding palm branches.
Es que tienen ramos de palma en las manos.
And we're going to be going over that a little bit later.
Y vamos a repasar eso un poco más después.
We might get to it today.
Tal vez toquemos sobre eso hoy.
Because for each of the holy days,
porque por cada día santo,
it's something about your hands.
Hay algo que ver con tus manos.
What is nice about Revelation 7,
lo que es bueno de Apocalipsis capítulo 7,
is there is a huge crowd.
Es que hay una gran multitud.
Just remember, it's only 25%,
acuérdate que es solamente 25%
of everybody that's ever lived.
De todos lo que han vivido desde el principio.
Because remember the four seeds that Yeshua talked about.
Acuérdate de las cuatro semillas que habló Yeshua.
So that's a pretty huge crowd of at least 2 billion people.
So eso es una multitud inmensa de como 2 billones de personas.
So the question one should ask,
so la pregunta que debes preguntar,
is, hi Arlene. The question everybody should ask.
La pregunta que todos deben hacer.
What makes you sure that you're going to be part of that 25%, Giselle?
¿Qué te hace seguro que vas a ser parte de esa 25%?
What makes you think that you're going to be part of the 25% over everybody else that's lived?
¿Qué te hace pensar que vas a ser parte de esa 25% de toda la gente que han vivido?
That's what the church doesn't understand.
Eso es lo que la iglesia no entiende.
What makes you think that God is going to allow you to stay?
¿Qué te hace pensar que Dios te va a permitir que te quede?
Sí.
Si continúo haciendo la voluntad del Padre, que es las fiestas, cumplir las fiestas, saber de las fiestas.
Okay, if as long as I continue to fulfill God's will in celebrating the seven Moedim,
y saber su palabra,
and knowing his word,
es lo que me va a ayudar a mí como humana,
that's what's going to help me as a human being,
a tratar de ser una hija buena para mi padre,
to try to be a good daughter to my father.
Pero eso es cada día,
but that's every day.
Leyendo,
reading. Reading so that you can correct yourself according to God's word.
It's not enough to just know.
No es suficiente solamente saber.
You have to implement it into your life.
Tienes que implementarlo en tu vida.
This, cada vez que leo la palabra, voy corrigiendo mi vida.
Yeah, that's what she says. She says that every time she reads the word, I begin to correct my life a little more according to the word.
Amen.
Amen.
I mean, that's what you have to look at. Sukkot is that reward for those who do change.
Sukkot es el premio para aquellos que sí cambian.
But if sometimes you're at Shabbat,
pero si a veces tú estás en Shabbat,
sometimes you're not,
a veces no estás,
sometimes you're at Bible study,
a veces estás en el estudio bíblico,
sometimes you're not,
a veces no estás,
That's being tossed by the wind.
Eso es el tirado por el viento.
Or tossed by the waves.
O tirado por las olas.
Sometimes a wave pushes you this way.
A veces la ola te empuja de este lado.
Sometimes a wave pushes you that way.
A veces la ola te empuja del otro lado.
Staying on the narrow path
manteniéndote en el camino angosto
means building your life around God's word.
Significa construyendo tu vida o edificando tu vida alrededor de la palabra.
And the reward is what you see here in Revelation 7.
Y el premio es lo que ves aquí en Apocalipsis capítulo
7. It's standing before the Lord.
Es parado al frente del Señor.
Was people from every nation.
Habían gente de todas naciones.
Tribe.
Tribus.
Language.
Lenguas.
And these, when you have the palm branch in your hand,
cuando tienes el ramo de palmas en tu mano,
that means you will stay there.
Eso significa que te vas a quedar ahí.
Because that's the second part of after you get the robe.
Esa es la segunda parte después que recibes la bata o el vestido.
But you only get the robe,
pero solamente recibes la bata,
if you follow God's ways.
Si sigue los caminos de Dios.
But if you don't,
pero si no,
if you put one face on here at congregation,
si pones una cara aquí en la congregación,
oh, hi, Margarita, how are you doing?
Hola, Margarita, ¿cómo estás?
Oh, that's a lovely rojo hat.
Eso es un red very magnífico.
Oh, and then as soon as you leave the congregation,
y ya cuando te vas de la congregación,
I hate Margarita.
Ay, odio Margarita.
You know, she's always so snooty.
Ella es bien creída.
If you have two faces,
si tiene dos caras,
then you're not going to find yourself in heaven.
Entonces no te vas a encontrar en la casa del Señor.
And the reward is a white robe.
Y el premio es una bata blanca.
And this beautiful palm in your hand.
Y esta palma bella en tus manos.
Going on to the next slide.
La próxima página.
Now we're going to go on to the next section, Intermediate 2.
Ahora vamos a entrar a la próxima sección, el estudio intermediario parte 2.
Going on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
Turn to Psalm 19, please.
Vamos a Salmos 19, por favor.
Psalm 19.
Salmos capítulo 19.
We're going to read verses 1 through 11.
Vamos a leer versículos 1 al 11. I was opening up the translator just in case I need to translate a word.
That's fine. Bible study, you can do the phone. Shabbat? No.
No, no, but it's just the translator.
Psalm 19.
Salmos capítulo 19.
Verse 1 through 11.
Versículos 1 al 11.
Everybody got it?
Todos lo tienen.
For the leader, a psalm of David. The heavens declare the glory of God. The dome of the sky speaks the work of his hands. Every day it utters speech. Every night it reveals knowledge. Without speech, without a word, without their voices being heard, their line goes out through all the earth, and their words to the ends of the earth, ends of the world. In them he places a tent for the sun, which comes out like a bridegroom from the bridal chamber with delight like an athlete to run his race. It rises at one side of the sky, circles around to the other side, and nothing escapes its heat. The Torah of Jehovah is perfect, restoring the inner person. The instruction of Jehovah is sure, making wise the thoughtless. The precepts of Jehovah are right, rejoicing the heart. The mitzvah of Jehovah is pure, enlightening the eyes. The fear of Jehovah is clean, enduring forever. The rulings of Jehovah are true. They are righteous altogether. More desirable than gold, than much fine gold, and sweeter than honey or drippings from the honeycomb. Through them, your servant is warned. In obeying them, there is great reward. Let's go on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
Let's look at verse 11.
Vamos a mirar el versículo 11.
Through them, your servant is warned. Oh, in obeying them, there is great reward. Okay, so in this psalm, we were talking about following the commandments.
En este salmo estaban hablando de seguir los mandamientos.
The word there in Hebrew for reward, the root word,
la palabra raíz en hebreo para premio,
is the Hebrew word akeb.
Es la palabra hebrea akeb.
It means a consequence.
Significa consecuencia.
Or a reward.
O un premio.
So Sukkot is a reward
Sukkot es un premio
for those who are obedient to the commandments.
Para aquellos que son obedientes a los mandamientos.
A consequence of good for your actions.
Una consecuencia de bien para tus acciones.
Remember last week we were talking about coming out of the great persecution.
Acuérdate que la semana pasada estuvimos hablando de salir de la gran persecución.
And as the world that we're living in is hating God more and more.
Y el mundo en la cual vivimos están odiando a Dios más y más.
They are hating truth.
Están odiando la verdad.
What we have to do if you believe in heaven, which I do.
Lo que tenemos que hacer si crees en el cielo como yo lo creo.
If you believe Yeshua the Messiah has come.
Si crees que Yeshua el Mesías ha venido.
Then your reward is.
Entonces tu premio es.
That you must follow the commandments.
Que debes de seguir los mandamientos.
And when you follow those commandments.
Y cuando sigues esos mandamientos.
When you follow those commandments.
Cuando sigues esos mandamientos.
The reward is a palm branch in your hand.
El premio es un ramo de palmas en tus manos.
Oh, you're like, well, what good is a palm branch going to do me?
¿Qué me va a servir un ramo de palmas?
Well, what good was holding that Super Bowl trophy?
¿Cuál fue el propósito de aguantar ese trofeo de Super Bowl?
Well, for Peyton Manning, it was $19 million.
Para Peyton Manning eran 19 millones de dólares.
For winning the Super Bowl, that's what he got.
Por ganar el Super Bowl, eso fue lo que él recibió.
What is your reward?
¿Cuál es tu premio?
What is your trophy?
¿Cuál es tu trofeo?
A white robe.
Una bata blanca.
And a palm branch in your hand.
Y un ramo de palmas en tus manos.
Means that you get a new place to live.
Significa que recibes un lugar nuevo para vivir.
How many people want a new place to live?
¿Cuántos quieren un lugar nuevo para vivir?
With no crime.
Sin crimen.
No, you don't have to pay rent.
No tienes que pagar renta.
How many people don't want to pay rent? How many people don't want to pay taxes?
¿Cuántos no quieren pagar impuestos?
Okay. How many people want a place where the streets are paved with gold?
¿Cuánto quieren un lugar a donde las calles son hechas de oro?
Well, that's your reward.
Ese es tu premio.
Look at verse 11 again.
Miren al versículo 11 de nuevo.
Through them your servant is warned. In obeying them there is great reward. It isn't just a little bit of a reward.
No es solamente un premio pequeño.
It is a great reward.
Es un gran premio.
And if we are servants of the Lord,
y si somos sirvientes del Señor,
then we should listen to our King.
Entonces debemos de escuchar
and,
a nuestro Rey.
And follow His commandments.
Sus mandamientos.
Follow His example.
Seguir su ejemplo.
What did Yeshua say?
¿Qué Yeshua dijo?
He said, lead me, right?
Él dijo, guíame.
Is that that's what he said, Oscar? He said, lead me.
Eso fue lo que él dijo, guíame.
He said, sígame, follow me.
Él dijo, sígame.
Sígame, follow me.
Follow me, sígame.
He said, walk in my footsteps.
Él dijo, camina mis pasos.
Pick up your cross.
Carga tu cruz.
Follow my example.
Sigue mi ejemplo.
And if we're servants of His,
y si somos siervos de él,
the song, King David here is writing
el Rey David aquí está escribiendo
in a reference to Sukkot,
en una referencia a Sukkot,
the great reward.
El gran premio.
Remember, David knew Yeshua.
Acuérdate que David conocía a Yeshua.
Because in Psalm 110, he says it.
Porque en Salmo 110, él lo dice.
Psalm 110, verse 1, he says it.
En el Salmo 110, verso 1, él lo dice.
The Lord said to my Lord.
El Señor le dijo a mi Señor.
And in the Hebrew, it's Adonai, Adoni, Father and Son.
En hebreo es Adonai, Adoni, Padre y Hijo.
So the reward is a consequence.
El premio es una consecuencia.
Of your actions towards Jehovah.
De tus acciones hacia Jehovah.
Okay. Sukkot is that reward.
Sukkot es ese premio.
Going on to the next slide.
Ahora en la próxima página.
Go back to verse 7 and 8.
Regresemos a los versículos 7 y 8 de Salmo capítulo 19.
Psalm 19, verse 7 and 8.
Salmo capítulo 19, versículos 7 y 8.
The Psalm that says that David knew the word.
Psalm 110, verse 1.
Verse 1.
The Lord said to my Lord.
Sit down at my right hand till I make thine enemies thy footstool.
Yes. Psalm 19, verse 7 and 8.
Salmos capítulo 19, versículos 7 y 8.
The Torah of Jehovah is perfect, restoring the inner person. The instructions of Jehovah is sure, making wise the thoughtless. The precepts of Jehovah are right, rejoicing the heart. The mitzvah of Jehovah is pure, enlightening the eyes. So we're going to look at perfection.
Vamos a mirar perfección.
By following the seven Kadosh Mikras,
siguiendo los siete Kadosh Mikras,
or they're also referred to as the Moedim,
o están referidos también como los Moedim,
they're, you're following perfection.
Está siguiendo perfección.
By following this perfection,
siguiendo esta perfección,
you'll be restored.
Vas a ser restaurado.
The inner person is restored.
La persona entraña va a ser restaurado.
So what happens after you die?
¿Qué sucede después que uno muere?
Your spirit returns to God, which gave it.
Tu espíritu regresa a Dios, quien lo dio.
So that inner person,
so esa persona de adentro,
will be restored back to God, the Father.
Va a ser restaurado de nuevo a Dios, el Padre.
Okay? Only
solamente
if you're following the holy days,
si está siguiendo los días santos,
and the commandment,
y los mandamientos,
in spirit and in truth.
En espíritu y en verdad.
Also, it says in verse 8,
también dice en versículo 8,
the precepts of Jehovah are right.
Los preceptos de Jehová son correctos.
So if God said to celebrate Sukkot,
so Dios dice que celebre a Sukkot,
on the 15th day of the 7th month,
en el día 15 del séptimo mes,
so do you wait till June? No, July.
So esperas hasta julio.
So we wait till July.
So esperamos hasta
July 15th, we're supposed to be celebrating the Lord's days.
El julio 15 estamos supuestos estar celebrando los días del Señor.
No, that's no. Absolutely incorrect.
Eso es absolutamente incorrecto.
But if you don't know God's laws,
pero si no conoces las leyes de Dios,
if you don't know His ways,
si no conoces sus caminos,
if you don't know His months,
si no conoces sus meses,
if you don't know how to sight the moon,
si no sabes vistar la luna,
then you're on the wrong days.
Entonces, estás en los días equivocados.
And then when you're standing there in heaven,
y estás, después, cuando estés parado ahí en el cielo,
and the Father comes to you, the King comes to you,
y el Rey viene a donde ti,
and says, David,
y dice, David,
where are your wedding clothes?
¿A dónde está tu ropa de boda?
They're in the dry cleaners.
Estás en el dry cleaner.
Are you gonna lie to God right to His face?
¿Y tú le vas a mentir a Dios en su
yeah, cara? Yeah, people will lie to God right to His face.
Yo creo que va a haber gente que le mienten a Dios a su cara.
So, what are the precepts?
So, ¿cuáles son los preceptos?
For this study,
para
it's
este estudio,
Pesach, Hag Matzah, Bikurim,
Shavuot, Yom Teruah, and Sukkot.
7 days.
7 days.
Primero.
First.
Pesach.
Pesach. Hag Matzah.
Bikurim.
Shavuot.
Yom
Teruah.
Yom Kippur.
Sukkot.
Okay, so if you're not doing those days,
so, si no estás celebrando esos días,
if you're celebrating Christmas,
si estás celebrando la Navidad,
or Easter,
o la Cuaresma,
then you are not following the precepts of Jehovah.
Entonces, no estás siguiendo los preceptos
because
de Jehovah.
You're telling him they're wrong.
Estás diciéndole a él que está equivocado.
Or they're not for me.
O que no son para mí.
And if they're not for you,
y si no son para ti,
then don't think you're going to get a white robe and a palm branch.
So no creas que va a recibir una bata blanca y un ramo de palmas.
Because they're not for you.
Porque no son para ti.
Hake mate.
Okay. Checkmate.
Okay. Also in verse 8.
También en el versículo 8.
It talks about following these precepts. It's going to rejoice your heart.
Habla de seguir estos preceptos que te va a traer gozo a tu corazón.
You know, people always say the law is bad.
La gente dice que la ley es mala.
King David had a different opinion.
Que el rey David tuvo una opinión diferente.
And since King David was very close to the Lord,
y como el rey David fue bien cercano al Señor,
and 3,000 years later we're still talking about him,
y 3,000 años después todavía estamos hablando sobre él,
and Yeshua never said to break them,
y Yeshua nunca dijo que lo quebrantara,
I'm going with King David and Yeshua.
Yo voy con el rey David y con Yeshua.
And following God's commandments makes my heart happy.
Siguiendo los mandamientos de Dios regocija mi corazón. Se regocija mi corazón.
It also says in verse 8,
también dice en el versículo 8,
the mitzvah of Jehovah are pure.
Los mitzvah de Jehovah son puros, o los mandamientos de Jehovah son
so
puros.
Keeping God's holy days is something that is pure.
So guardando los días santos de Jehovah es algo puro.
And you'll get a reward.
Y vas a recibir un premio.
And what is that reward?
¿Y cuál es ese premio?
Wedding clothes.
Ropa de boda.
So that you get to have a seat at the wedding feast.
Para que tengas un asiento en la fiesta de la boda.
But if you're not putting on those clothes of righteousness,
pero si no te estás poniendo esa ropa de justicia,
see, I'm covered in the blood.
Yo estoy cubierto en la sangre.
What was covered in blood?
¿Qué estaba cubierto en la sangre?
What was covered in blood?
¿Qué estaba cubierto en
Rosa?
La sangre?
What was covered in blood?
¿Qué estaba cubierto de sangre?
Huh? Are you doing your lemon impression? What was covered in blood?
El pecado.
Sin. Sin. What do you think, Betsy? What was covered in blood?
¿Qué estaba cubierto de sangre?
Porque era pecado.
What was sin?
See, people love to say, I'm covered in the blood of the Lamb.
Hay gente que dice que yo estoy cubierto en la sangre del Cordero.
You're covered in the blood for the sin.
Tú estás cubierto en la sangre para el pecado.
But God says, put on this robe.
Dios dice, ponte esta bata.
This robe of righteousness.
Esta bata de justicia.
He said the mitzvah here in verse 8
dice, la mitzvah, los mandamientos aquí en verse
are
8,
pure.
Son puro.
So when somebody says you don't have to be circumcised,
cuando alguien dice que no tiene que ser circuncidado,
and men don't have to be circumcised,
que los hombres no tienen que ser circuncidados,
that is something that is impure.
Eso es algo que es impuro.
Because God said to circumcise the male.
Porque Dios dijo que circuncidara el varón.
That is pureness.
Eso es puro. Eso es pureza.
God said, keep the Sabbath holy.
Dios dijo, mantén, que guarde el Shabbat como santo.
That is pure.
Eso es puro.
It enlightens you.
Eso te alumbra.
Because the whole goal is to run the race.
Porque la meta es correr la carrera.
But you have to run the race by the rules of the race.
Pero tienes que correr la carrera de acuerdo de las reglas de la carrera.
You can't like get in your car.
No puede get in your car?
Yeah.
No puede entrar a tu carro.
Say it's a marathon race.
Vamos a suponer que es un maratón.
So you run a mile.
So tú corres una milla.
And then you get in your car.
Y después entra, te montas en el carro.
And you drive 24 miles.
Y manejas 24 millas.
Park your car.
Lo estacionas.
And get out to run the rest.
Y sales para correr el resto.
That's wrong, right?
Eso es malo, ¿no?
So if God is saying, keep my commandments,
so, si Dios está diciendo, guarda mis mandamientos,
then you have to run the race the way he says.
Tienes que correr la carrera como él dice, como él manda.
Because when you're doing these holy days,
porque si estás haciendo, si estás guardando esos días santos,
it's practice,
es práctica,
for putting on the white robe,
para vestirse de la bata blanca.
And what to do with that palm branch.
¿Y qué hacer con ese ramo de palmas?
So that when you get to God's house,
so, para cuando llegues a la casa,
you're not going to be going to the person next to you.
No vas a hablar con la persona que está al lado de ti.
Hey, what do we do with these things?
Hey, ¿qué hacemos con esas cosas?
what do we do with this?
¿Qué hacemos con esto?
You don't know?
¿Tú no sabes?
I'm going to stand over here.
Yo me voy a parar aquí.
Here comes the king. He'll tell you. That's what's going to happen.
Eso es lo que va a suceder.
And then what are you going to reply?
Y después, ¿qué vas a responder?
But Lord,
pero Señor,
we preached in your name.
Predicamos en tu nombre.
But Lord,
pero Señor,
we healed in your name.
Sanamos en tu nombre.
But Lord,
Señor,
we raised dead in your name.
Levantamos los muertos en tu nombre.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
And the Lord's going to say, who's Jesus?
El Señor va a decir, ¿quién es Jesús?
So here, the reward is to rejoice in God's ways.
Aquí el premio es para regocijar en la carrera de Dios.
Going on to the next slide.
A la próxima página.
Let's go on to verse 4 and 5. Back to verse 4 and 5.
Regresemos a los versículos 4 y 5 de Salmo capítulo 19.
Verse 4 and 5.
Versículos 4 y 5.
Psalm 19, verse 4 and 5.
Salmos 19, versículos 4 y 5.
Their line goes out through all the earth, and their words to the ends of the world. In them he places a tent for the sun, which comes out like a bridegroom from the bridal chamber, with delight like an athlete to run his race. In verse 5,
en el versículo cinco,
there are two references.
Hay dos referencias.
that reference Yom Kippur,
que son referencias a Yom Kippur,
and then reference Sukkot.
Y también, dan referencia a Sukkot.
In verse 5,
en versículo cinco,
we see the bridegroom coming out from the bridal chamber.
Ves al novio que sale de la cámara nupcial.
That means that the marriage has been consummated.
Eso significa que fue consumado la boda.
Okay. And now he's coming out.
Y ahora él está saliendo.
To now finish the race.
Para terminar la carrera.
How many days are there between Yom Kippur?
¿Cuántos días hay entre Yom Kippur
and Sukkot, Claudia?
Sukkot.
How many days?
¿Cuántos días?
I'll do it like Kermit the Frog. How many days is there between Yom Kippur and Sukkot? 15 days between those two?
15 entre los dos?
You're going to miss the party.
Tú te vas a equivocar. Va a perder la fiesta. Yom Kippur y Sukkot.
How many days, Adriana?
¿Cuántos días?
No, Ruthie.
Ruth.
Ooh, oh, now she double fanged me. Well, how many days between Yom Kippur? Escucha.
Listen. Listen to me.
How many days between Yom Kippur and Sukkot?
¿Cuántos días entre Yom Kippur y Sukkot? What?
All right, let me see. Let's see. Diana on the Skype land. Diana, how many days between Yom Kippur and Sukkot?
¿Cuántos
días entre Yom Kippur y Sukkot?
10.
10 days? You're going to seriously miss the party. All right, let's see here. Let's see here. Evelyn. Evelyn.
11.
Evelyn, 11. How many days between Yom Kippur and Sukkot?
8 days. 8 days.
Evelyn? Raina! Revitin Raina! How many days between Yom Kippur and Sukkot?
I'm coming.
Oh, you're coming, Evelyn. How many days?
Race. I was running the race. I didn't know how to get to you from where I was.
Whoa.
57?
How many?
57.
57? Boy, you guys are going to be late.
After the Shabbat, then comes 50 days.
Wait, let me ask. Kamaluch!
Carmen,
how many days between Yom Kippur and Sukkot?
15 days.
Between.
7.
7. You're going to miss the party. All right. Yom Kippur falls when, David? See. Yom Kippur is on what day?
About
10th day of the 7th month. Yom Kippur falls on the 10th day of the 7th month. Okay. Now translate that. Yom Kippur falls.
Yom Kippur cae.
On the 10th day of the 7th month.
El décimo día del séptimo mes.
Write this down, everybody.
Escriban esto, todos.
Sukkot falls on the 15th day of the 7th month.
Séptimo mes.
So how many days?
So cuántos días?
How many days, Evelyn?
¿Cuántos días, Evelyn?
Or, no, wait, let me go back to Diana. Diana, how many days between... between Yom Kippur and Sukkot.
Entre Yom Kippur y Sukkot.
5 days.
Gloria a Dios.
Praise God, Baruch Hashem.
Baruch Hashem. 5 days. Cinco días. 5 days. So he got to run a race for 5 more days.
So va a correr una carrera por 5 días más.
So let's go back to Psalm 19.
Vamos a regresar a Salmo 19.
Verse 5.
Verso 5.
Which comes out like a bridegroom from the bridal chamber.
Yes.
With delight like an athlete to run the race. So he comes out of the chamber, that is Yom Kippur.
So él sale de la cámara nupcial, eso es Yom Kippur.
The day is over.
Ya se acabó el día.
You've now broken the fast.
Se rompió el ayuno.
Now he's going to run the rest of the race.
Ahora va a correr el resto de la carrera.
Because it's going to be, what does the number 5 mean?
Porque ¿qué significa el número 5? Grace.
Grace.
Gracia.
It's the number for grace.
Es el número para gracia.
Got to know these things, people.
Tiene que saber estas cosas.
No matter what.
If no importa qué.
They take your Bible away, you better put this in your memory.
Si te quitan la Biblia, te tiene que mantener esto en tu memoria.
It is life. And what's coming.
Esto es vida y lo que viene.
Yes.
There is a chart on the website.
Hay un...
With the holiday and the day that it falls.
Yes.
I think, yeah.
There's lots of things on the web. But if they're going to take your... If they're going to take your Bible away, don't think that our website's going to be there.
No crea que nuestro sitio web va a estar ahí.
No. In Revelation,
en Apocalipsis,
there's a fourth seal that gets opened.
Hay un cuarto sello que se abre.
And 25% of the world dies.
Y 25% del mundo muere.
There's going to be a lot of disruption of many things.
Va a haber mucha interrupción de muchas cosas.
But it doesn't mean you don't have to do the holy days.
Pero no significa que no tienes que hacer los días santos.
Here in verse 5,
aquí en el versículo 5,
it talks about an athlete running his race.
Habla sobre un atleta corriendo su carrera.
Whether you're a real athlete,
si eres un atleta real,
or a spiritual athlete,
o un atleta espiritual,
you have to be trained how to run your race.
Tiene que ser entrenado cómo correr la carrera.
And no matter what, these things have to be done.
Y no importa qué, estas cosas tienen que ser hechas.
And there's so many things going on in the world today.
Y hay tantas cosas que están sucediendo en el mundo hoy.
There's so much news going on.
Hay mucha noticia que está ocurriendo.
So much prophecy going on.
Mucha profecía que se está cumpliendo.
But God's word will not stop.
Pero la palabra de Dios no parará.
Nor will his holy days.
Ni tampoco sus días santos.
And if I'm dead, I'm happy.
Y si yo estoy muerto, yo estoy alegre.
But it doesn't mean that you can stop following God.
Pero no significa que tú puedes dejar de seguir a Dios.
The responsibility for your heart is your own.
La responsabilidad de tu corazón es tuyo.
My job as a teacher is to teach you.
Mi función como maestro es enseñarte.
My job is to show you how important things are.
Mi trabajo es enseñarte lo cual importante son las cosas.
And it's sort of like teaching the children in our school.
Es como enseñarle a los niños en nuestra escuela.
Because they're coming out of the public school system.
Porque ellos están saliendo del sistema escolar público.
They don't understand how important certain things are.
Ellos no entienden cuán importantes son ciertas cosas.
And how important education is.
Y lo importante que es educación.
Knowledge is power.
La sabiduría es poder.
And then I'll quote a cartoon.
Y voy a citar una caricatura.
And I like power.
Y a mí me gusta el poder.
You got to be plugged into the power.
Tiene que estar enchufado al poder.
How do you plug into the power?
¿Cómo te enchufas al poder?
You stick your tongue in a light socket? No, you plug your mind into God's word.
No, tú te enchufas la mente en la palabra de Dios.
Then you can run the race.
Entonces puedes correr la carrera.
Because if you don't finish the race,
porque si no terminas la carrera,
then you're not going to get your white robe.
Entonces no vas a recibir,
and you're not going to get your palm branch.
Y no vas a recibir tu ramo de palmas.
Going on to the next slide.
Ahora vamos a la próxima página.
Now let's talk about running the race.
Ahora vamos a hablar sobre correr la carrera.
Intermediate 2, run race.
Intermediario 2, correr carrera.
Turn to 1 Corinthians 9.
Vamos a Primera de Corintios capítulo 9.
1 Corinthians 9.
Primera de Corintios capítulo 9.
Oh, I got fanged by you too?
Robinson, you fanged Rabbi. Run race.
1 Corinthians 9.
Primera de Corintios, capítulo 9.
Verse 24 to 26.
Versículos 24 al 26.
If you're taking notes, this is the run race section.
Si está tomando notas, está la sección de correr carrera.
What do you need?
I should
check those calendars. Sure. Everybody say hello to Brittany.
Hi, Brittany.
Now it's going to be on the web. Watch.
Oh.
That would be bad.
Yeah, no, leave the bakery up
Wait.
There. Leave the bakery up there.
Now.
You don't want to mess up the
careful,
donuts.
Careful, careful. It's leaning forward.
Don't mess up the donuts. They're on sale.
She needs help, all right. 1 Corinthians 9,
Primera de Corintios, capítulo 9,
verse 24 to 26.
Versículos 24 al 26.
Don't you know that in a race, all the runners compete, but only one wins the prize? So then run to win. Now every athlete in training submits himself to strict discipline, and he does it just to win the laurel wreath that will soon wither away. But we do it to win a crown that will last forever. Accordingly, I don't run aimlessly, but straight for the finish line. I don't shadow box, but try to make every punch count. Going on to the next slide, let's look closer at verse 24.
Vamos a mirar en la próxima página el versículo 24.
Don't you know that in a race, all the runners compete, but only one wins the prize? So then run to win. Run to win.
Corran para ganar.
The holy days are the race.
Los días santos son la carrera.
Following God's Moedim, his holy days,
siguiendo los Moedim de Dios, sus días santos,
is that race.
Es esa carrera.
And the prize is a white robe
y su premio es una bata blanca,
and a palm branch in your hand.
Y un ramo de palmas en tus manos.
This is what the Rabbi Paul Shaul was talking about.
De esto es lo que estaba hablando el Rabino Shaul, Pablo.
Remember, he's talking to a Hellenistic society.
Acuérdate que él está hablándole a una sociedad helenística.
This is what many people forget because they don't study history, they don't study the Word.
Esto es lo que mucha gente se olvida porque no estudian historia y no estudian la palabra.
Between the Old Testament,
entre el Viejo Testamento,
and the book of Malachi,
y el del libro de Malaquía,
and the book of Matthew,
y el libro de Mateo,
is a 400-year period.
Hay un periodo de 400 años.
It is called the dead period.
Se llama el periodo muerto.
Where God did not speak for 400 years.
A donde Dios no habló por 400 años.
He was giving us the silent treatment.
Él no estaba dando el tratamiento silencio.
Because he was fed up with our lives.
Porque él ya estaba cansado con nuestras vidas.
And when he gets angry,
y cuando él se enoja,
you get sad.
Tú te pones triste.
And this is what Yeshua is referencing when he talks about Matthew 24.
Y esto es lo que se estaba refiriendo Yeshua en Mateo 24.
Had the days not been cut short,
que si los días no fueron cortados,
nobody would survive.
Si los días no fueran hechos cortos, nadie sobreviviría.
So getting to the Feast of Sukkot,
llegando a la fiesta de Sukkot,
is running a race.
Es corriendo la carrera.
All the runners compete. Everybody is invited.
Todos los que van están corriendo compiten.
That's why we started out with the Matthew scripture.
Por eso que comenzamos con la escritura de Mateo.
Remember in the Matthew scripture, we're all invited to the wedding.
Acuérdate que en la escritura de Mateo todito estamos invitados a la boda.
They went out to everywhere to invite everybody to come.
Que salieron a todo lugar para invitar a todo el mundo que viniera.
What is this competing that Paul is talking about?
¿Qué es este competir que está hablando Pablo?
We're competing against the world.
Estamos compitiendo contra el mundo.
We're competing against ourselves.
Estamos compitiendo contra nosotros mismos.
You're competing against yourself.
Tú estás compitiendo contra tú mismo.
Because yourself wants to do the world's ways.
Porque tu carne quiere hacer las cosas de.
Because it's easy.
Porque es fácil.
The children don't want to do the work.
Los niños no quieren hacer el trabajo.
They'll do whatever they can to not do the work.
Van a hacer todo lo que pueda para no hacer el trabajo.
And I'm sure you can all think about your own lives.
Y creo que todos pueden pensar sobre su propia vida.
When you were a kid.
Cuando eras niño.
And your parents would tell you, study.
Y tus padres te decían, estudia.
Yeah, I did my homework, ma.
Sí, sí, yo hice mi tarea, ma.
And you didn't do your homework.
Y tú no hiciste tu tarea.
But now you wish you could go back.
Pero ahora, desearías regresar.
How many people wish we could go back?
¿Cuántos desean que podamos regresar?
Okay. Yes, Giselle. You want to go back?
¿Tú quieres regresar?
Yeah, but we can't.
Pero sí, no podemos.
But God tells us through his servant Shaul.
Dios nos dice a través de su siervo Shaul.
He's talking to Jewish believers.
Él está hablando a creyentes judíos.
Converts to Messianic Judaism.
Conversos al judaísmo mesiánico.
Compite. Win the prize.
Ganar el premio.
What prizes are we winning in the Bible?
¿Qué premios estamos ganando en la Biblia?
What did it say in Revelation?
¿Qué dijo en Apocalipsis?
That white robe.
La bata blanca.
And the palm.
Y la palma.
Run to win.
Corran para ganar.
What does it mean to run to win?
¿Qué significa correr para ganar?
Remember in the book of Revelation that we studied last week.
Acuérdate que en el libro de Apocalipsis que en cual estudiamos la semana pasada.
These are the ones that come out of the great persecution.
Esos son los que salen de la gran persecución.
And we're looking at that now, people.
Y estamos viendo eso ahora.
If you looked at the news over the last 4 days,
si has visto en los últimos 4 días,
your spirit would be telling you, here it comes.
Tu espíritu te dirá que aquí viene.
Here it comes.
Aquí viene.
So knowing this knowledge is vitally important.
Teniendo esta sabiduría es sumamente importante.
You have to run to win.
Tienes que correr para ganar.
Understand Revelation.
Entienda Apocalipsis.
This great persecution.
Esta gran persecución.
Going on to the next slide.
En la próxima página.
Look at verse 25.
Miremos al versículo 25.
Now every athlete in training submits himself to strict discipline, and he does it just to win a laurel wreath that will soon wither away. But we do it to win a crown that will last forever. Strict discipline, he says.
Disciplina estricta, él dice.
What kind of discipline would we be under, Paul, since you say we're under grace?
¿Qué clase de disciplina estaríamos debajo si tú no dices que ganar la carrera?
So this is how you get the Christians who say we don't need the law anymore.
Así es como tú coges al cristiano que dice que no necesitamos hacer la ley.
Strict discipline.
Disciplina estricta.
To what?
¿A qué?
He's only writing to Corinth.
Solamente le está hablando escribiendo a Corintios.
Printing didn't come until way later.
La impresa no llegó hasta más después.
How did you get a copy of the Torah?
¿Cómo es que recibías una copia de la Torah?
Somebody had to write it.
Alguien lo tenía que escribir.
Handwritten.
Escrito a mano.
Somebody had to handwrite it.
Alguien tenía que escribirlo a mano.
Paul didn't send emails.
Paul no mandó este correo electrónico.
Hey Peter, did you get my text message?
Pedro, ¿recibiste mi texto?
Did he call Peter?
¿Llamaste a Pedro?
Did he call?
¿Llamaste?
So what is he talking about? What would Corinth have and Ephesus have?
So ¿de qué él estaba hablando? ¿Qué tenía Corintio y qué tenía Éfeso?
What would the congregation in Rome have?
¿Qué tenía la congregación en Roma?
What would they all have that would be the same?
¿Qué tendrían ellos todos que sería
Ruthie,
igual?
What would they have all that would be the same?
¿Qué tendría ellos todos que sería lo mismo?
Dial up? What would they all have?
Internet bien lento.
What would Rome...
Rosa.
What would Rome,
¿qué tendría Roma,
Ephesus,
Efesio,
and Corinth all have at their congregations?
Tuvieran todos en su congregación.
Pizza.
Pizza.
What's that in front of you, Rosa?
¿Qué es eso que tienes al frente de ti?
A Biblia, Bible. They would have the Old Testament.
Tuvieran las escrituras del Viejo Testamento.
They would have the Torah.
Tuvieran el Torah.
So when he's saying strict discipline,
cuando él dice disciplina estricta,
discipline to what?
Disciplina a qué?
God's commandments.
A los mandamientos de Dios.
Just turn it off. To God's commandments.
A los mandamientos de Dios.
So if we're strict with God's commandments in our lives,
so si somos estrictos con los mandamientos de Dios en nuestra vida,
you'll get the crown in Revelation.
Vas a recibir la corona en Apocalipsis.
Discipline when the world hates what you stand for.
Disciplina cuando el mundo odia por lo que tú te paras firme.
Willing to lose everything.
Disponible a perder todo.
To gain eternity.
Para recibir la eternidad.
One of the hardest things that's going to happen to America.
Una de las cosas más difíciles que va a suceder aquí en América.
Because we're such a fat nation.
Porque aquí somos tan una nación gorda.
We're so bratty.
Somos tan engreídos.
We're so undisciplined.
Somos tan sin disciplina.
Even some of the Europeans.
Hasta algunos de los europeos.
That are going to fight with ISIS.
Que van a pelear contra ISIS.
They're getting killed.
Ellos están siendo matados.
By the people from ISIS.
De la gente de ISIS.
They were saying, they were complaining, there's no place to plug in my iPod.
Ellos están diciendo que no hay ningún lugar a donde enchufar mi iPod.
This is people's lives.
Esto es la vida de la gente.
Instead of the word.
En vez de la palabra.
So Paul is talking about strict discipline.
So Pablo estaba hablando sobre disciplina estricta.
To win a crown that lasts forever.
Para recibir una corona que dura para siempre.
And Sukkot is that reward.
Y Sukkot es ese premio.
So even if you've made mistakes in the past,
so aunque hayas cometido errores en el pasado,
you got to let those things go.
Tienes que soltar esas cosas, dejar
you got to put those things away.
Tienes que guardar esas cosas, echar esas
so
cosas
that you could fuera. Win the race.
Para que puedas ganar la carrera.
Going on to verse 26.
Vamos al versículo 26.
Accordingly, I don't run aimlessly, but straight for the finish line. I don't shadow box, but try to make every punch count. Paul is referencing Sukkot in this.
Pablo está dándole referencia a Sukkot en esta escritura.
And how do I know that?
¿Y cómo sé esto?
The word's finish line.
La palabra, el término, la meta.
What's the finish line?
¿Qué es la meta?
The eighth day of Sukkot.
El octavo día de Sukkot.
That's the finish line.
Esa es la meta.
Running aimlessly, what is that?
Corriendo sin rumbo, ¿qué es eso?
When you start doing things that are not found in Scripture.
Cuando haces las cosas que no está encontrado aquí.
Running straight for the finish line.
Corriendo directamente para la línea, la meta.
What does that mean?
¿Qué significa eso?
Remember when Yeshua said.
Acuérdate lo que dijo Yeshua.
Go in through the narrow gate.
Entren por la puerta estrecha.
Because if you're going aimlessly, you're going to run into the wall.
Porque si corres sin rumbo, sin propósito, vas a chocar contra la pared.
He says, make every punch count.
Él dice que haga cada golpe contar.
That means don't waste your time with things that are not in the Word.
Él significa que no pierdas tu tiempo con cosas que no se encuentra en la palabra.
Because people will lie.
Porque la gente mentirá.
People will steal.
La gente van a robar.
People will cheat.
La gente van a hacer trampa.
People will be two-faced.
La gente van a ser de dos caras.
But God does not honor any of that.
Pero Dios no honra nada de eso.
Making every punch count.
Hacer que cada golpe cuente.
Means making every day count.
Significa que hagas que cuente cada día.
Every day.
Cada día.
Because what happens if you're backslidden?
Porque ¿qué sucede si te descarreas?
And that bomb goes off.
Y esa bomba explota.
You're not going to have time to repent.
Tú no vas a tener tiempo de arrepentir.
Then you're going to be up at that wedding feast.
Y vas a estar en esa fiesta de boda.
And the king's going to come to you.
Y el rey va a venir a donde ti.
Oh, where are your wedding clothes?
Y preguntar, ¿a dónde está tu ropa de boda?
I didn't get any.
Yo no recibí ninguno.
Right.
Ah, verdad.
Get the hell out of here.
Sal de aquí.
Going to send you to hell.
Te va a mandar al infierno.
Where you'll have a lovely cell for yourself.
A donde tendrás una celda para ti solo.
with a mattress that has maggots in it.
Con un colchón que tiene gusanos.
Crawling up your nose.
Entrando en tu nariz.
In your ears.
En tus orejas.
Up your legs. Ah, 75% of the world that's ever lived is going to have that.
75% de la población del mundo que desde el principio va a tener eso.
You can't say that.
Tú no puedes decir eso.
I didn't.
Yo no lo dije.
The Lord did.
El Señor lo dijo.
My master.
Mi maestro.
The leader of our sect, Yeshua said it.
La cabeza de nuestra secta, Yeshua, él lo dijo.
He said it.
Él fue que lo dijo.
I just say what he says.
Yo solamente repito lo que él dijo.
Sometimes not as nice as him.
A veces no tan bueno como él.
But remember, Yeshua called people dogs,
acuérdate que Yeshua llamó a gente
animals,
animales,
and Satan worshippers.
Y adoradores de Satanás.
So sometimes he got a little aggravated with people.
So a veces él se enojó un poco con la gente.
So don't run aimlessly.
So no corran sin rumbo.
Learn how important these holy days are.
Aprendan lo importante que son estos días.
Not to me.
No para mí.
To my king.
Para mi rey.
Because I'm not in charge of your salvation.
Porque yo no estoy a cargo de tu salvación.
I'm just going to tell you what you need to do.
Yo solamente te voy a decir lo que tienes.
And you don't want to believe me? That's cool.
Y si no me quieres creer, está
bien. One day you're going to find out.
Un día te vas a enterrar.
And I'm going to say,
y te vas a decir, bye.
See, you wouldn't want to be you.
Adiós, no quiero ser como tú.
And you said the congregation would fail.
Y tú dijiste que la congregación iba a fracasar.
I can't tell you how many people tell me that this congregation is going to fail.
Yo no te puedo contar cuánta gente me han dicho que esta congregación va a fracasar.
Right, Reverend Veronica?
¿Verdad, Reverend Veronica?
Yeah. Cool.
¿Ah?
Good, I'll have less to do.
Bueno, tendría menos que hacer.
But since it's not my congregation,
pero como no es mi congregación,
it doesn't say Andrew Dinnerman Ministries.
No dice ministerios de Andrew Dinnerman.
Like Benny Hinn.
Como Benny Hinn.
Paula White.
Paula White.
What's the other?
Jimmy Swagger.
Jimmy Swagger. No, what's the other lady? Joyce.
Joyce Myers.
Myers. Clown. Okay. Don't run aimlessly.
No corran sin rumbo, sin
problema. The finish line here,
la meta aquí,
and why we're talking about it, is Sukkot.
De lo que, y por qué estamos hablando es Sukkot.
It's the last holy day, the finish line.
Es el último día santo, la meta.
What is the last holy day of the year?
¿Cuál es el último día santo del
David
año?
Jr., what is the last holy day of the year?
¿Cuál es el último día santo del año?
Sukkot, he says.
Sukkot.
He did the lemma. Going on to the next slide.
Ahora vamos a la próxima página.
Intermediate number two.
Intermediario número dos.
If you're writing notes, I entitled this section The Wedding Feast.
Esta parte se titula La Fiesta de Boda.
Wedding Feast.
La Fiesta de Boda. La fiesta nupcial.
Going on to the next slide.
Ahora en la próxima página.
Revelation 19, please.
Apocalipsis capítulo 19, por favor.
Verse 7 through 9.
Versículo 7 a 9.
Revelation 19.
Apocalipsis capítulo 19.
Anybody got any questions on running the race?
¿Alguien tiene preguntas sobre correr la carrera?
Any questions on running the race?
¿Preguntas sobre correr la carrera?
Revelation 19, verse 7 through 9.
Apocalipsis capítulo 19, versículo 7 a 9.
Revelación 19, versículo 7 a 9.
Revelation 19, verses 7 to 9.
Got it, Ruthie?
I'm waiting for the screen.
Let us rejoice and be glad. Let us give him the glory. For the time has come for the wedding of the Lamb, and his bride has prepared herself. Fine linen, bright and clean, has been given her to wear. Fine linen means the righteous deeds of God's people. The angel said to me, write, how blessed are those who have been invited to the wedding feast of the Lamb. Then he added, these are God's very words. Now, who's talking here?
Ahora, ¿quién está hablando aquí?
Who's talking to who?
¿Quién le está hablando a quién?
Who's talking to who?
¿Quién le está hablando a quién?
Rosa, who's talking to who?
Rosa, ¿quién le está hablando a quién?
SpongeBob is talking to Patrick?
SpongeBob le está hablando a Patricio.
Gary, Gary, run the race. SpongeBob, how blessed are those who have been invited to the wedding feast of the Lamb. Who's talking to who there? Hey, Frank, who's talking here?
¿Quién está hablando aquí?
Who's talking to who?
¿Quién está hablando aquí? The angels?
Who's the angel?
¿Quién es el ángel?
Are you sure?
¿Estás seguro?
Well, who's the angel?
¿Quién es el ángel?
And who's the angel talking to?
¿Y a quién le está hablando el ángel?
The angel talking to SpongeBob?
El ángel está hablando a SpongeBob.
De padre de Adonai a Yeshua. No?
No. Frank, your voice changed.
It's good ventriloquism.
Who's talking to who in the book of Revelation?
¿Quién está hablando a quién en el libro de la Apocalipsis? Yeshua.
Sí.
To John.
Oh, todo bien.
Sí. Everything good.
Okay. A Jew is talking to a Jew.
Un judío le está hablando a un judío.
The angel,
el ángel,
said to me, write how blessed those have been invited to the wedding feast of the Lamb.
Me dijo que escriban cuán bendecidos son aquellos que han sido invitados a la fiesta nupcial del Cordero.
Who's he telling to write?
¿A quién le está diciendo que escriba? Yohanan. Yohanan. Juan.
Not Yohanan the Immerser, he's dead.
No, Yohanan el Bautista, él está.
The one that leaned back into Yeshua's chest.
El que se recostó en el pecho de Yeshua. His brother. That's what he said.
Whose brother?
Yeshua's brother.
Juan.
John.
James. John's not his. James is his brother.
James is his, well. Yaakov.
Yeah, this is Yohanan that's writing it. John.
In the island of Patmos.
Right. So, why would they reference the wedding feast?
¿Por qué hacen referencia a la fiesta nupcial?
Well, every Jew understands
que todo judío entiende
that the wedding feast
que la fiesta nupcial
is a reference to Sukkot.
Es la referencia a Sukkot.
But if you only study the New Testament, you're clueless as to that.
Pero si solamente estudias el Nuevo Testamento, no tiene idea de lo que están haciendo referencia.
You're clueless.
No tiene idea.
So the wedding feast
so la fiesta nupcial
happens after the ceremony.
Sucede después de la ceremonia.
Because the ceremony is where you wear the linen.
Porque la ceremonia es a donde tienes puesto el lino.
That's verse 8. That's Yom Kippur. The righteous deeds of God's people.
Es las obras de justicia del pueblo de Dios.
How do you get righteous?
¿Cómo te haces justo?
When in Scripture
¿cuándo en las escrituras
are your sins forgiven?
¿Están tus pecados perdonados? Yom Kippur.
Yom Kippur.
En Yom Kippur.
It's the day God takes the sins away, each and every year.
Es el día que Dios quita los pecados cada año.
Who is the bride, Diana? We are the bride.
¿Quién es la novia? Nosotros somos la novia.
Because Yeshua calls himself the bridegroom.
Porque Yeshua se llama, él se deja conocer como el novio.
And we are the bride.
Y nosotros somos la novia.
The righteous deeds of God's people.
Las obras justas de pueblo de Dios.
Who are God's people?
¿Quiénes son el pueblo de Dios?
Anyone who wants to be following the commandments.
Aquellos que quieran seguir los mandamientos.
Okay. Going on to the next slide.
Ahora en la próxima página.
Now we're going to start getting towards the Torah.
Ahora vamos a entrar más a la Torah.
Okay, now we're taking the next section.
Ahora vamos a tomar la próxima sección.
Okay, and we can easily go to all the references of bride that would take us 6 months.
Podemos entrar a todas las referencias de novia que nos tomará 6 meses.
But I want to try to keep this down to a 30-part series.
Quiero tratar de mantener esto a una serie de 30 partes.
And if you missed any part of these,
y si te perdiste alguna parte,
they are all on our website.
Están todos en nuestro sitio.
Also, the PowerPoints are there.
Y también las presentaciones están ahí.
I think what I'm going to have the Colombians start doing.
Creo que lo que voy a hacer que los colombianos hagan.
Or maybe Adriana.
O tal vez Adriana.
Rabbi,
I wanted. Is that somebody on Skype?
Yes.
Go ahead, Diana.
We are just a wedding guest.
Diana.
Yes. If we are the bride, who is the wedding guest?
The wedding guest. What part are you referencing?
When you were talking about earlier that the wedding guest was not wearing his garment.
You're talking about the Matthew scripture, the Matthew 22 scripture?
Yes.
Okay. We play a dual role.
Nosotros tenemos un...
Is your mic on?
My mic is on.
Okay.
Hello?
Yeah, okay.
Nosotros tenemos como un doble papel.
Just like as we were studying,
igual como estábamos estudiando,
Yeshua is the Lamb of God for Passover.
Yeshua es el Cordero de Dios para Pesach.
But he's also the Azazel who takes away the sins of the world.
Pero también es el Azazel que quita los pecados del mundo.
So we are the bride.
So somos la novia.
Each person is a bride of Messiah.
Cada persona es una novia de Mesías.
Because he says, I go to prepare a place for you.
Porque él dice que voy a preparar un lugar para ti.
Singular.
Singular.
Then we are his guests at his house at the wedding feast.
Entonces somos sus invitados en la fiesta nupcial en su casa.
You see how you have to read the Bible as a whole.
Tienes que leer la Biblia como algo entero.
Okay, Diana? Oh, thank you, she says. All right. Now, going on to the next section, regalim.
Ahora, en la próxima sección, regalim.
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 Please turn in your next slide to Deuteronomy 16.
Vamos a la próxima página y abrimos nuestra Biblia a Deuteronomio capítulo 16.
Deuteronomy 16.
Deuteronomio capítulo 16.
Verse 13.
Versículos 13.
Through 17.
Al 17.
Okay, now we're going to start getting into a little bit more.
Ahora vamos a entrar un poquito más
of what we have to do
de lo que tenemos que hacer
to get that white robe,
para obtener esa bata blanca,
to get that palm branch,
para obtener ese ramo de palmas,
to be the bride of Messiah.
Para ser la novia de Mesías.
Because remember, Messiah is a Jew.
Acuérdate que Mesías es un judío.
He's not going to a Catholic church for a wedding.
Él no se va a casar en una iglesia católica.
Okay? Not going into that pagan institute.
No va a ese instituto pagano.
He's not going to marry somebody who keeps Sunday worship.
Él tampoco se va a casar con alguien que guarda adoración del domingo.
Because that would be unevenly yoked.
Porque eso sería un yugo desigual.
And he says, don't be unevenly yoked.
Y él dice, no seas yugo desigual.
Deuteronomy 16, Deuteronomio 16, versículo 13 a 17.
Deuteronomy chapter 16, verses 13 to 17.
You are to keep the festival of Sukkot for 7 days, after you have gathered the produce of your threshing floor and winepress. Rejoice at your festival, you, your sons and daughters, your male and female slaves, the Litvaim and the foreigners, orphans and widows living among you. 7 days you are to keep the festival for Yehovah your Elohim in a place where Yehovah your Elohim will choose. Because Yehovah your Elohim will bless you in all your crops and all your work, so that you be full of joy. 3 times a year all your men will appear, or men are to appear in the presence of Yehovah your Elohim in the place where he will choose. The festival of Matzah, the festival of Shavuot, and the festival of Sukkot. They are not to show up before Yehovah empty-handed, but every man is to give what he can in accordance with the blessing Yehovah your Elohim has given. Okay? Did not Yehovah know?
No, Jehovah no sabía
that we would be living here in America,
que estaríamos viviendo aquí en América,
that the temple would not be up for 2,000 years,
que el templo no estaría, levantado por 2,000 años.
So does that mean we don't have to do the holy days until the temple is up?
So eso significa que no tenemos que celebrar los días santos hasta que se construya el templo.
What do you think, Betsy?
¿Qué piensas?
Being more interactive today.
The what?
I'm being more interactive today.
Estoy siendo un poco más interactivo hoy.
Huh? Didn't he know that we were going to be living in Ecuador or Colombia or Brazil or Argentina? Puerto Rico?
Puerto Rico.
Hi, Sarah.
She didn't understand the question.
He says,
él dice,
three times a year you have to appear.
Tres veces al año tenemos que...
Oh, Sarah, it's not that bad. She banged her head.
¿Qué fue? Right, he knew that we were going to live all over the world.
So where he puts his name?
So a donde él pone su, su nombre?
The place he will choose.
En la, el lugar a donde él escojas.
Okay, while the temple's not there.
Mientras el templo no esté ahí.
Now once the temple's there,
ya cuando el templo esté construido,
but it hasn't been there for 2,000 years.
Que no ha sido, que no ha estado ahí por 2,000 años.
But in Leviticus 23,
pero en Levíticos capítulo 23,
he says, no matter where you live.
Él dice, no importa donde vivas.
So he's got to have a place that's following his commandments.
So tiene que tener un lugar que está siguiendo sus mandamientos.
Going on to the next slide.
Ahora en la próxima página,
let's look at verse 14.
Miremos al versículo 14.
Rejoice at your festival, you, your sons and daughters, your male and female slaves, the Litvaim, and the foreigners, orphans, and widows living among you. Okay? Now here is something that the body doesn't see.
Aquí hay algo que el cuerpo no ve.
Jehovah's saying in verse 14,
Jehovah está diciendo en el versículo 14
that the ordained feasts
que en la fiesta ordenada
are not only for the Jew.
Que no es, es solamente para los judíos.
Okay, because he says the foreigners.
Porque él dice los extranjeros.
So who would be a foreigner?
So ¿quién sería un extranjero?
Anybody who's not born of this, the bloodline of Abraham, Yitzhak, and Yaakov.
Aquellos que no son de la línea de Abraham, Yitzhak, y Jacob.
Okay. Let's read verse 14 again.
Vamos a leer el versículo 14 de nuevo.
Rejoice at your festival, you, your son, and daughters, your male and female slaves, the Levites, and the foreigners, plural, orphans, and the widows living among you. Okay, so here he's wanting everybody to celebrate the feast.
So aquí él quiere que todos celebren la fiesta.
He doesn't want just Jewish people celebrating them.
Él no solamente quiere que los judíos lo celebren.
Everybody's invited.
Todos están invitados.
This goes back to the Matthew scripture.
Esto regresa a la escritura de Mateo.
The king said, I prepared the feast for my son.
El rey dice que yo he preparado la fiesta para mi hijo.
Go invite everybody.
Vayan e inviten a todos.
The feasts are for everybody to keep them.
Las fiestas son para que todos los guarden.
Okay, even if you're a foreigner.
Hasta si eres extranjero.
God invites everybody to his house.
Dios invita a todos a su casa.
And you come if you want to be there.
Y tú llegas si quieres estar ahí.
That's why it ties together with the Matthew scripture.
Por eso que se enlaza junto con la escritura de Mateo.
You see that it's also plural.
Ves que también es plural.
Foreigners as in plurality.
Extranjeros como más de uno.
Orphans as in plurality.
Huérfanos como más de uno.
Widows, plurality.
Viudas, más de uno.
Okay, so here Jehovah's saying, I want everybody at Sukkot.
Aquí Jehová está diciendo que quiero que todos se presenten para Sukkot.
I want everybody at Shavuot.
Quiero que todos estén ahí para Shavuot.
What else did he say, Frank? What other holy day does he want everybody at?
El santo que él quiere que todos estén ahí.
Pesach?
Pesach.
Hello.
I'm going to have you answer the questions tomorrow.
Chamasah, Sukkot, Shavuot.
Si.
Did
they teach you this at the institute?
Okay. Get
your money
back.
Get your money back. Going on to the next line.
Ahora vamos a la próxima página.
Let's do verse 14 and 15
vamos
now.
A leer versículos 14 y 15.
Rejoice at your festival, you, your sons, and daughters, your male and female slaves, the Levites, and the foreigners, orphans and widows living among you. 7 days you are to keep the festival for Jehovah your Elohim in the place Jehovah your Elohim will choose, because Jehovah your Elohim will bless you in all your crops and in all your work, so that you are to be full of joy. So here we're looking now at verse 15.
Ahora estamos mirando el versículo 15.
That all the people that are coming,
que todos los que van a llegar,
God said, if you do this, running this race,
si Dios dice que si ustedes corran esta carrera,
I'm going to bless you in your crops.
Te voy a bendecir en tus cosechas.
Why is that really something amazing?
Porque eso es algo bien interesante.
Yes. Why does he say the crops?
Porque él está diciendo las cosechas.
Sarah, why?
Sarah, ¿por qué?
Oh, she's doing the lemma stare. Why Sarah?
¿Por qué, Sarah? ¿Por qué? She's like, I can't get the words out, but I know the answer. No.
Why is he saying in the crops? What's so important about the crops, Giselle?
¿Qué es tan importante de las cosechas?
Your name is Giselle, right? The nombre de Giselle? Adriana.
Para comer.
To eat.
You want to expand upon that?
¿Quiere elaborar un poquito más sobre eso?
Because it's important to eat.
It's important to eat.
Comer.
But it's also because, isn't that it says there not to come empty-handed?
We didn't get to that yet, Mary.
Oh, that's what I was thinking.
But you want to do the other part that Adriana is talking about.
La otra parte de que está hablando Adriana.
So you eat.
Comes.
See, when you're eating,
cuando estás comiendo,
it means you're prosperous.
Significa que eres próspero.
If you're prosperous,
próspero,
you'll have children.
Vas a tener hijos.
If you have children,
hijos,
nobody's going to attack you because you've got a large family.
Nadie te va a atacar porque tiene una familia grande,
to protect your land.
Para proteger tu terreno.
So the Lord says, if you keep my holy days, rejoice at my holy days.
So Señor dice que si igualas mis días santos,
key is rejoicing.
La clave es ser gozoso.
One's Passover. When is Passover?
¿Cuándo es Pesach?
You know, there's a lot of people like, when's Shabbat over?
¿Cuándo se acaba Shabbat?
So I can get home. I want to go home.
Ya me quiero ir a la casa.
Now, there are a lot of people that don't like the whole, when do we got to do this?
¿Cuándo tenemos que hacer esto?
Oh, my boss is going to give me all this garbage.
Mi jefe me está dando toda esta basura.
But if you rejoice and you can't wait for God's
pero
holy
si
days,
te regocijas y no puedes esperar para los días santo de Dios.
So God is saying, rejoice,
Dios está diciendo que te
keep his festival,
guarde su festival,
give everybody who's working for you,
dale a todo lo que está trabajando para
invite
ti.
Them to your day,
invítalos a tu día.
Okay? And then God says,
y después Dios dice,
he will choose a place to put his name in your land,
él va a escoger un lugar para poner su nombre en tu terreno,
because remember he says, no matter where you live,
porque acuérdate que él dice, no importa dónde vivas.
So no matter where you're living, if you're following God's commandments,
so no importa dónde vivas, si estás siguiendo los mandamientos de Dios,
he says, I'm going to bless you in your crops.
Él dice que te voy a bendecir en tus cosechas.
How is he going to bless the crops?
¿Cómo él va a bendecir las cosechas?
Going to give it rain.
Le va a dar lluvia.
Maim Chaim, living
Maim
water.
Chaim, agua viva.
Living water.
Agua viva.
You're going to have the proper amount of water.
Va a tener la cantidad apropiada de agua.
Not too much.
No mucho.
Not too little.
No muy poco.
He's going to give you just the right amount.
Te va a dar la cantidad correcta.
And then all your work is going to be joyful.
Y entonces todo tu trabajo va a ser gozoso.
Wow, look at all this stuff we got. We can sell some and pay off our debt.
Mira, todo lo que tenemos, podemos vender un poco y saldarnos de nuestra deuda.
God said, I'm going to give you so much that you'll be able to throw out next year.
Dios dice que te voy a dar tanto que vas a poder botar el próximo año.
Going on to the next slide.
Ahora la próxima página.
Now we're going on to intermediate 2.
Ahora estamos entrando en intermediario número 2.
We're going to Leviticus.
Vamos a Levíticos.
We're going to read a large section.
Vamos a leer una sección larga.
Next slide of chapter 23.
The what?
We're going to read a large section of chapter 23.
Vamos a leer una sección larga del capítulo 23.
We're going to go to chapter 23 of Leviticus, Miqra.
Vamos a Levíticos capítulo 23.
Verse 33 through 44.
Versículos 33 al 44.
Now we'll slow down.
Ahora voy a take it easy.
Leviticus 23.
Leviticus capítulo 23.
Verse 33 through 44.
Versículos 33 al 44.
Leviticus 23. Diana, mute please.
Levíticos capítulo 23, versículos 33 al 44.
Jehovah said to Moshe, tell the people of Israel, on the 15th day of the 7th month, the feast of Sukkot, for 7 days, to Jehovah. The first day there is to be a holy convocation. Do not do any kind of ordinary work. For 7 days, you are to bring an offering made by fire to Jehovah. On the 8th day, you are to have a holy convocation and bring an offering made by fire to Jehovah. It is a day of public assembly. Do not do any kind of ordinary work. These are the designated times of Jehovah that you are to proclaim as holy convocations, bring an offering made by fire to Jehovah, a burnt offering, grain offering, sacrifice, and drink offering, each on its own day. Besides the Shabbats of Jehovah, your gifts and all your vows and all your voluntary offerings that you give to Jehovah. But on the 15th day of the 7th month, when you have gathered the produce of the land, you are to observe a festival of Jehovah 7 days. The first day is to be a complete rest. Then the 8th day is to be a complete rest. On the first day, you are to take choice fruit, palm fronds, thick branches, and river willows, and celebrate in the presence of Jehovah your Elohim for 7 days. You are to observe it as a feast to Jehovah 7 days in the year. It is a permanent regulation. Generation after generation, keep it in the 7th month. You're to live in Sukkot for 7 days. Every citizen of Yisrael is to live in a sukkah, so that generation after generation of you will know that I have made the people of Israel live in Sukkot when I brought them out of the land of Egypt. I am Jehovah your Elohim. Thus Moshe announced to the people of Israel the designated times of Jehovah. And now we're going to break that passage down.
Ahora vamos a dividir esta escritura.
Let's go back to verse 34 and 35.
Regresemos a los versículos 34 y 35. Disculpa.
Tell the people of Israel, on the 15th day of the 7th month is the feast of Sukkot for 7 days to Jehovah. On the first day there is to be a holy convocation. Do not do any kind of ordinary work. Okay? So the first part we look at here,
la primera parte que vamos a mirar aquí,
is on the 15th day.
Es en el día 15.
What is something that we're always going to see on the 15th day of God's month?
¿Qué es algo que vamos a ver siempre en el día 15 de los meses de Dios?
What do you think, Rosa?
Full moon. Una luna llena.
We're going to see a full moon.
Vamos a ver una luna llena.
So you're going to know you're going to be on the right day.
So vas a saber que estás en el día correcto.
If you're celebrating,
si lo estás celebrando,
this feast when you see the full moon in the sky in the 7th month of God's year.
Este festival, si lo estás celebrando con la luna llena en God's year.
In God's year.
En el año de Jehová.
Okay.
De Jehová.
Okay, it's the 7th month.
Es el séptimo mes.
Now, on this first day,
ahora, en este primer día,
it is also a holy convocation, a Kadosh Miqra.
Es también un Kadosh Miqra, una santa convocación.
Okay? Like the other holy days
como los otros días santo,
of Hag Matzah,
de Hag Matzah,
Bikurim,
Shavuot,
Yom Teruah,
Yom Kippur,
you have no work is commanded.
No se puede trabajar, es mandado.
Do not do any kind of ordinary work.
No hagas ningún clase de trabajo ordinario.
So that means If your job is driving a bus,
si significa si tu trabajo es manejar un autobús,
then you're not driving.
Entonces no estás manejando.
If your job is a mechanic,
si eres mecánico,
then you're not fixing cars that day.
Entonces no estás arreglando carros ese día.
Okay, in case, unless there's an emergency.
A menos que haya una emergencia.
Unless there's an emergency.
A menos que haya una emergencia.
Then the emergency supersedes.
Entonces la emergencia sobrepasa.
The holy day.
El día santo.
But let's focus on the holy day itself.
Pero vamos a enfocarnos en el día santo.
So ordinary work is not changing a diaper.
So, trabajo ordinario no es cambiar un pañal.
That's different every time.
Eso es diferente cada vez.
Okay? It's different every time.
Es diferente cada vez.
All right? So feeding a baby is not ordinary work.
Dándole de comer no es trabajo ordinario.
Ordinary work is something, ordinary work,
trabajo ordinario,
is something that you do for payment.
Es algo que tú haces para que te pague. Yeah,
a carpenter.
Un carpintero.
Or whatever.
O lo que sea.
Whatever other job you might have.
Cualquier otro trabajo que tengas.
So verse 35 again.
So el versículo 35 de nuevo.
On the first day there is to be a holy convocation. Do not do any kind of ordinary work. Any kind.
Cualquier clase.
Okay. So can I work a few hours?
Puedo trabajar un par de horas.
Would that be any kind of work, Ruthie?
Eso sería algún... ¿Alguna clase de trabajo? ¿Algún clase de trabajo?
What do you think?
¿Qué crees?
What do you think there, Ruth?
¿Qué
piensas?
Yeah, no work. No work.
Ningún clase de trabajo.
Okay, so that's one of the criteria that we have to follow.
Ese es uno de los criterios que tenemos que seguir.
So, you know, the Christians who don't follow any of the holy days,
los cristianos que no siguen ninguno de los días santos,
they're not going to be getting their palm branches,
ellos no van a recibir sus ramos de palma,
and they're not going to be getting a white robe,
y ellos no van a recibir una bata blanca,
because they don't know when the 15th day of the 7th month is,
porque ellos no saben cuándo el día 15 del séptimo mes es,
but their heart does.
Pero su corazón sí lo sabe.
Because when Adam bit the fruit,
porque cuando Adán mordió la fruta,
he now knew all good and evil.
Reconoció todo bien y el mal.
How do we know what is good and evil?
¿Cómo sabemos lo que es bien y el mal?
Well, we're children of Adam and Chava, right?
Somos hijos de Adán y Chava.
But the other part is we have the Bible now.
La otra parte es que tenemos la Biblia ahora.
The other part is,
la otra parte es,
we have Yeshua as an example.
Tenemos Yeshua como ejemplo.
So we have no excuse.
So nosotros no tenemos excusa.
Okay, so a holy convocation.
So una convocación santa.
What is a holy convocation?
¿Qué es una convocación santa?
Who wants to answer what a holy convocation?
¿Quién quiere responder qué es una convocación
santa? Oh, let's go over to the Skype land.
Vamos a la tierra de Skype.
Ellen! Ellen! Ellen!
Ellen!
Can you tell me what a holy convocation is? Ellen! No, Ellen? Okay, who wants to tell me what a holy convocation is?
¿Quién quiere responder que es una convocación santa?
Can you do a holy convocation at your house?
¿Puede hacer una convocación santa en tu casa?
Where are you supposed to do it?
¿A dónde estás supuesto a hacerlo? In the congregation.
In the congregation.
En la congregación.
You're supposed to do it at the congregation.
Está supuesto hacerlo en la congregación.
It's leaving where you are,
es saliéndote de donde estás,
to a place that's set aside for a particular purpose.
Para un lugar que es apartado para un propósito en particular.
Okay, so you can't do it at your house.
No lo puedes hacer en tu hogar.
Okay, you're supposed to be among God's people. Doing it.
Está supuesto estar entre el pueblo de Dios celebrando.
Okay, it is a convocation.
Es una convocación.
Okay, well, what does a convocation mean?
¿Qué significa una convocación?
A coming together.
Una asamblea, reuniéndose.
Going on to the next slide.
Ahora en la próxima página.
Let's look at verse 36, please.
Vamos a mirar el versículo 36, por favor.
Verse 36.
Versículo 36.
For 7 days you are to bring an offering made by fire to Jehovah. On the 8th day you are to have a holy convocation and bring an offering made by fire to Jehovah. It is a day of public assembly. Do not do any kind of ordinary work. Okay? When you see something with just 7 days,
cuando ves algo que dice siete días,
that you are to bring an offering,
que tienes que traer una ofrenda,
that is the temple offering.
Ese es, la ofrenda del templo.
Because if everybody was doing it at their house,
porque si todos lo estaban haciendo en su hogar,
you would deplete the entire stock of bulls.
Este, terminarías el este, todo el ganado de toros.
Let's say you had 600,000 people.
Supongamos que tenía 600,000 personas.
Offering up a lamb.
Ofrendando un cordero.
For 7 days.
Por 7 días. That's a lot.
That's a lot of lamb.
That's a lot.
So cookie. Let's say. So seven times six. Where's Brittany?
Siete por seis.
Okay. 7 times 6 is what?
42.
So you had 600,000 men.
Tiene 600,000 hombres.
How much would it be?
¿Cuánto sería?
For 7 days.
Por 7 días.
600,000.
Yes.
It's 42,000,000.
42,000,000.
42 millones.
So, do you think God wants 42 million? 4,200,000, that's what I thought.
Oh, yeah.
Because you're adding too many zeros.
Yeah.
No, when in doubt, just do the six zeros.
Yeah.
So, 7 times 6 is 42.
7 times 6 is 42.
600,000 men.
600,000 men is 4,200,000.
So that's 4,200,000.
4,200,000.
So logically, do we think the Lord is going to want 4,200,000 lambs?
So lógicamente, ¿crees que el Señor quiere 4,200,000 corderos?
No.
No.
So that is the temple offering.
So esa es la ofrenda del templo.
But there are offerings that we have to do.
Pero hay ofrendas que tenemos que hacer.
On certain days.
En cierto días.
So when it says for 7 days you're to bring an offering.
So cuando dice por 7 días tienes que traer una ofrenda.
That's specific for the temple.
Eso es específico para el templo.
Sí.
But okay, it says for 7 days you're to bring an offering made by fire to Adonai. That's for the temple. What? How? I mean, here, how are you going to bring an offering by fire?
Maybe. It's called Rav Will's altar.
Oh, okay, so...
He does it for our congregation.
Oh, he does it, right, okay.
7 days?
Yes.
Every day he makes an offering?
Yes, he does. Wow. We have pictures of it. It's up on our website.
Well, I know that.
You should experience our website.
No, yeah, right. You should.
If you go to... I think we have the pictures for all the holy days last year, all the offerings.
So then I know he does it for the congregation. But isn't the congregation supposed to bring the offering?
He's bringing it for us.
He's bringing it for us. Okay.
He's doing because the priest.
El, mi pregunta es que
si his question is.
Mi pregunta es que si por siete días estamos supuestos a traer una ofrenda hecha por fuego, entonces cómo es que nosotros lo hacemos? Pero el rabino me dice que Rab Will hace la ofrenda.
His question of the offering that was going up in fire.
Es de la ofrenda que sube, que es el holocausto.
Ah.
So he offers.
He offers it. You go to our website.
Vas a nuestro sitio web.
You click on last year's Sukkot.
Oprimas en el Sukkot del año pasado.
Okay.
There's pictures.
Hay fotos.
Of the offering.
The offering
beef. Did you do beef or? I think you did.
It was beef.
I think it was a.
Yeah.
You did the cow.
Yeah, I think it was the cow.
Cow? I'm not sure. Yeah, I think it was cow.
I think it was the cow.
Okay. Yes, every day. With special clothing and everything. Yes. Well, with salt.
Con sal.
Can we go there?
Yes, you can go to his house.
Where are we going?
Okay. Now, let's reread this.
Ahora vamos a leer esto de nuevo.
Verse 36.
Versículo 36.
For 7 days you are to bring an offering made by fire to Jehovah. On the eighth day you are to have a holy convocation and bring an offering made by fire to Jehovah. It is a day of public assembly. Do not do any kind of ordinary work. So for 7 days is the temple offering.
So por siete días es la ofrenda del templo.
Then there's an eighth day offering.
Entonces hay una ofrenda del octavo día.
That is for everybody.
Eso es para todos.
That you're supposed to be there.
Que está supuesto estar ahí.
It's a day of public assembly.
Es un día de asamblea pública.
We're not going to go over that in this week's study.
No vamos a repasar eso en este, en el estudio de esta semana.
We're going to get to that next week.
Vamos a tocar sobre eso la semana.
We're going to do the first day first.
Vamos a hacer el primer día primero.
But just understand that on the first day
entiendan que en el primer día,
and the eighth day
y el octavo día,
is a Kadosh Miqra.
Es un Kadosh Miqra.
So day 2 through 7,
el día 2 al 7,
can you work?
Puedes trabajar.
What do you think, Claudia? But is anybody in agreement? You can work or no work?
No work. No, you can work.
There's 8 days.
Hay 8 días.
So day 2
día dos
through 7
al día siete,
can you work?
Puedes trabajar, yes.
Yes. Yeah, you can. It's only the first and the
eighth.
Mm-hmm.
So day 2
día dos
through 7
al siete,
you can work.
Se puede trabajar.
Because it says a convocation.
Porque dice una convocación.
Is the there's an 8 day convocation.
Hay una convocación en el octavo
and
día.
A day 1 convocation.
Y en el primer día.
For the other days, you can work.
Pero los otros días puedes trabajar.
Going on to the next slide.
Ahora en la próxima página.
Verse 37.
Versículo 37.
These are the designated times of Jehovah that you are to proclaim as holy convocations and bring an offering made by fire to Jehovah. A burnt offering, a grain offering, a sacrifice, and drink offering. Each on its own day. Okay? So there are 4 types of offerings. I wrote 3. That's an error.
Hay 4 clases de ofrendas. Yo escribí 3. Eso es un error.
Burnt offering.
Un holocausto.
Grain offering.
Ofrenda de grano.
Sacrifice.
Sacrificio.
And drink.
Y ofrenda de trago. De trago.
We will be going over that later on.
Vamos a repasar eso más después.
What each offering is meant.
¿Qué significa cada ofrenda?
Okay. We're just doing the overview part right now.
Solamente estamos repasando ahorita mismo.
But we will be going over the 4 offerings.
Pero sí vamos a tocar más profundo en las diferentes tipos de ofrendas.
That's why we got at least another 3 weeks of this.
Por eso que tenemos a mínimo 3 semanas sobre este.
Okay, so there's 4 offerings.
Hay 4 ofrendas.
Burnt offering.
Holocausto.
Grain offering.
La ofrenda de grano.
Sacrifice offering.
El sacrificio.
And drink offering.
Y la ofrenda de trago.
So these things that you got to understand,
y estas cosas que tienes que entender,
no matter what happens in the world,
no importa lo que suceda en el mundo,
you got to find some way of doing this.
Tiene que buscar la manera de hacer esto.
Yes, Adriana.
So, Rabbi Willie brings an offering, the main offering from the whole congregation. But each person has to bring these offerings, like individual offerings?
No. The offering, Rab Will does all these offerings.
Rabino Will hace todas estas ofrendas.
There's going to be something that each person has to do.
Va a haber algo que cada persona tiene que hacer.
He does the drink offering to sacrifice the grain and the burnt offering.
Él hace la ofrenda del holocausto, de grano, de sacrificio y el de trago.
The burnt offering is an olah.
El holocausto es un sacrificio de olah.
That goes in your belly.
Eso entra,
if you're a priest,
si eres sacerdote,
you eat it.
Te lo comes.
Claudia.
How that counts, having somebody doing the offerings for us if we're not there?
Huh? How does he do the offering since we're not there?
Oh, ¿cómo él hace la ofrenda para nosotros si nosotros no estamos ahí?
¿Cómo eso cuenta para nosotros?
How does that count for us?
Because he's doing it instead for us, as How did it work in the temple? If you're not, you don't have to be there for day 2 through 7. But they're still doing the offering to the Lord for 7 days. You're commanded to be there for Sukkot, not for the whole feast.
Generally,
if you're going to be there for day 1, you're going to be there for day 8. Stay there.
Generalmente, si va a estar ahí por el día, el primer día va a estar ahí para el octavo día.
But you don't have to be. It's not commanded.
Pero no tienes que estar ahí. No es ordenado.
So, but they're still doing the offerings.
Pero ellos todavía están haciendo la ofrenda.
How is it still interceding for Israel?
¿Cómo es que está todavía intercediendo para Israel?
Rav Will has built an altar.
El Rabino Will ha construido un altar.
In accordance with Torah.
De acuerdo con Torah.
He gets animals that are slaughtered in accordance with Torah. Clothing that is according to Torah.
El vestimento que es acuerdo con Torah.
And does it, the offering, in accordance with Torah.
Y hace la ofrenda en acuerdo con Torah.
For this house of Beth Goyim.
Para esta casa de Beth Goyim.
Because it says, no matter where you live.
Porque dice, no importa donde viva.
Yo pienso que es muy cómodo, no puedo entender. O sea, es una sola persona haciendo las ofrendas y cómo nosotros cooperamos para que eso cuente para nosotros.
She's saying that it's just one person doing the offerings for us, but how does it count for us, para nosotros?
¿Cómo cuenta para nosotros?
How does it count for us if we're not giving nothing?
Because how did it count for you in the time of the temple?
¿Cómo contaba para ti en el tiempo del templo?
If you were not the one giving the offering.
Si tú no eras la que estaba dando la ofrenda.
How many persons were, who was doing the offering?
¿Quién estaba haciendo la ofrenda?
The Kohen Hagadol.
El sumo sacerdote.
How did it count for all of Israel?
¿Cómo contaba para todo Israel?
And the people that were not counted, they didn't have to be there from day 2 to 7.
Y las personas que no estaban contados porque no tenían que estar ahí del día 2 al 7.
Same pattern.
El mismo patrón.
He's doing it, he's praying to God and he's saying this is for Beth Goyim.
Él está orándole a Dios y él está diciendo que esto es para Beth Goyim.
See?
Where did they get, during the time they were doing offerings, where do they get the offering from? Like, from where the livestock?
¿De dónde recibían el ganado?
Who, Rav Will?
No, the time of the...
In the temple.
The time of the temple.
They had... flocks and herds.
Ellos tenían
like
ganado.
From anybody that donated or like
they yeah, had, but they would inspect them.
Their own?
The Levites had their own.
Los Levitas tenían sus propios.
But the people could give too that they can inspect from also.
Este también podía dar, pero ellos inspeccionaban el,
it just has to be perfect.
Tenía que ser perfecto.
Okay. Maybe I understand your question, like perhaps if we want to like give an offering to them. To help them to get whatever, you know what I mean?
Like, how are you gonna? Let's
know.
Take
yes,
it.
Right.
Let's take it back.
Okay, vamos a regresar un poco.
How do you eat the Passover?
¿Cómo tú comes el Pesach?
Were you here this past Passover?
¿Tú estabas aquí este último Pesach?
How did you eat?
¿Cómo comiste?
Did you have some lamb?
¿Comiste cordero?
Yes.
Who cooked that lamb for you?
¿Quién cocinó ese cordero?
Did you pick out the lamb?
Yeah, no, you didn't.
But that's what I'm trying to show you.
Pero eso es lo que te estoy tratando de demostrar.
Same way.
La misma manera.
Same way.
Yeah, well, I know in other congregations they charge a lot of money for it. That's what
yo sé que en otras congregaciones ellos cobran mucho dinero por eso.
Brothers and sisters, even they don't charge. People give good offerings. That's what I'm thinking.
I trust God.
Yo confío en
but,
Dios.
You know, I know I'm an idiot.
Yo sé, yo soy idiota.
But God expects us, you know.
Yes,
you know,
we take up an offering.
That's what I'm thinking.
Passover is for everybody who wants
Pesach
to come.
Es para aquellos que quieren estar.
I don't want somebody not to come because they can't afford it.
Yo no quiero que alguien no venga porque no tienen los recursos.
My Lord said, go invite everybody.
Mi Dios, mi Señor, me dijo, invite a todos.
In Egypt, we were poor.
En Egipcio, éramos pobres.
And everybody was invited.
Y todos fueron invitados.
And it's the same here.
Y es igual aquí.
That's what Beth Goyim is about.
De eso lo que es, se trata Beth Goyim.
You know, that's, I don't think the Word of God should be charged for.
Yo no pienso que debo de cobrar por la palabra de Dios.
I don't think we should stop anybody from coming.
No creo que debemos de evitar que algunos lleguen.
Who wants to be part.
Que quiere ser parte.
So them charging a lot of money.
So aquellos que cobran mucho dinero.
The other thing is they're going to a restaurant.
La otra parte es que ellos van a un restaurante.
We're doing it here in our humble place.
Lo estamos haciendo aquí en nuestro lugar humilde.
This year we might even cook it right here.
Este año tal vez lo cocinemos aquí mismo.
Because Pesach most likely will fall on Shabbat.
Porque Pesach tal vez va a caer en Shabbat.
So remember,
so acuérdense,
the holy day supersedes the Shabbat.
El día santo sobre pasa el Shabbat.
So we might go get a grill.
So tal vez
a vamos new grill
una parrilla nueva
that's never been used.
Que nunca ha sido usado.
We'll get the lamb on Thursday.
Buscamos el cordero el jueves.
I don't think we can slaughter it. I don't think we can slaughter in here.
No creo que lo podamos matar aquí.
But we will have it butchered.
Pero lo vamos a que lo corten.
And we will cook it.
Y lo vamos a cocinar.
Over the fire.
Sobre el fuego.
That'll be a good thing for all the men.
Eso va a ser algo bueno para todos los hombres.
And it'll smell real good.
Yeah, and the backs is going to go a little too. Right, Rav? Ed? Don't forget the tortillas with lime.
We're not having tortillas on Passover.
Oh,
no yeah. Leavening. Going on to the next slide.
En la próxima página. Tortillas don't have leavening.
Verse 38 and 39.
Versículos 38 al 39.
Besides the Shabbat of Jehovah, your gifts, all your vows, and your voluntary offerings that you give to Jehovah, but on the 15th day of the 7th month, when you had gathered the produce of the land, you had to observe the festival of Jehovah 7 days. The first day is to be complete rest, and the 8th day is to be complete rest. So the keys for these couple of verses.
Las claves para estos versículos.
Besides the gifts and voluntary offerings.
Aparte de los regalos y los votos y las ofrendas voluntarias.
Now you're bringing something to the house.
Ahora está trayendo algo para la casa.
You're bringing the produce of the land for Sukkot.
Está trayendo la cosecha de la tierra para Sukkot.
This is a festival. This is a feast.
Este es un festival, es una fiesta.
So everybody's to bring food, kosher foods. So
todos están tienen que traer comida kosher.
It is a feast with all different spices.
Es un festival con muchas especies.
Okay, so here it is the produce of the land.
Aquí es producto de la tierra, la cosecha de la tierra.
And this is on the first day and on the 8th day.
Es en el primer día y en el octavo día.
Once again, we have 2 times we're going to have a feast.
Nuevamente tenemos 2 veces que vamos a tener una fiesta.
And we expect everybody to bring.
Y esperemos que todos traigan.
Whatever you can do.
Lo que puedan.
But if you've been following the Lord, you should be blessed.
Pero si estás siguiendo el Señor, debes de ser bendecido.
Okay? So it's a feast, a great feast.
Es un festival, un gran fiesta, una gran fiesta.
This is the wedding feast. There's going to be an abundance.
Es un festival nupcial. Va a haber una abundancia.
So here on earth,
so aquí en la tierra,
we're practicing.
Estamos practicando.
We're practicing for that wedding feast.
Estamos practicando para esa fiesta nupcial.
Going on to the next slide.
Ahora en la próxima página.
Verse
40. Versículo 40.
On the first day, you're to take choice fruit, palm fronds, thick branches, and river willows, and celebrate in the presence of Jehovah your Elohim for 7 days. Now, this verse, verse 40,
versículo 40,
is what we read about in Revelation.
Es lo que leímos en Apocalipsis.
In Revelation, what was in their hands?
En Apocalipsis, ¿qué tenían en las manos?
A palm branch.
Un ramo de palma.
Why was there a palm branch?
Porque había un ramo de palma.
Because they were the ones that celebrated Sukkot on the right day.
Porque ellos eran los que celebraron Sukkot en el día correcto.
It'll be your reward.
Será tu premio.
The reward.
Tu premio.
For following God's ways.
Por seguir los caminos de Dios.
What is in our hands?
¿Qué está en nuestras manos?
It is the palm.
Es la palma.
Let's go on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
Verse 41.
Versículo 41.
You are to observe it as a feast to Jehovah 7 days in the year. It is a permanent regulation. Generation after generation, keep it in the seventh month. God says it's permanent.
Dios dice que es permanente.
So when people say you only can do this at the temple,
cuando la gente dice que solamente puede hacer esto en el templo,
then they're the 9-second believer.
So ellos son los creyentes de 9 segundos.
Because God says it's permanent, it's oyam.
Porque Dios dice que es permanente, es oyam.
Oyam or olam, whichever way you want to say.
Oyam o olam, cualquier manera que quiera.
It is perpetual, it is everlasting.
Es perpetuo, es duradero.
So for the last 2,000 years, wherever you are, you're supposed to have kept this.
En los últimos 2000 años, a donde quiera que he estado, tienes que guardarlo.
And if you didn't understand permanent regulation,
y si no entendiste regulación permanente,
you saw generation after generation.
Viste generación tras generación.
Okay, so just in case didn't know anything.
Por si acaso no sabía.
Okay, you're to observe.
Hay que observar.
What does it mean to observe?
¿Qué significa observar?
That means active participation.
Significa participación activa.
So that means everybody's got to do something to help facilitate this holy day.
So eso significa que todos tienen que compartir para facilitar este día santo.
And keep it in the seventh month.
Y mantenerlos en el séptimo mes.
Not the secular seventh month, God's seventh month.
No en el séptimo mes secular, sino en el séptimo mes de Dios.
This will be generally around our September, October, ninth month, tenth month.
Generalmente será entre septiembre y octubre.
This year, I believe it's in October. It's on our website.
Este año creo que cae en el décimo mes secular.
It is late this year.
Es tarde este año.
Because we have a leap year this year.
Porque tenemos un
leap year.
Okay? Un año bisiesto.
And do we see leap year in the Bible?
¿Vemos año bisiesto en la Biblia?
No.
No.
But how do you tell the beginning of the year?
Pero ¿cómo conoces el principio del año?
Well, if you're going to have a first fruit offering, don't you think there's got to be something coming up out of the ground?
Si vas a tener una ofrenda de primer fruto, ¿no crees que tiene que haber algo que está creciendo?
So it's winter in Israel.
Es invierno en Israel.
There's nothing coming. It's cold.
Es frío.
Nothing's going to be growing even next month.
Nadie va a crecer ni el mes que viene.
So you can't have an offering in the winter.
So no puedes tener una ofrenda en el invierno.
Going on to verse 42.
Ahora en el versículo 42
and 43.
Y 43.
Next slide.
Próxima página.
You're to live in Sukkot for 7 days. Every citizen of Israel is to live in a sukkah. So generation after generation of you will know that I made the people of Israel live in a sukkah when I brought them out of the land of Egypt. Okay? Now we're going to look at the Hebrew here.
Ahora vamos a ver el hebreo aquí.
Because we're looking at every citizen.
Estamos viendo a cada ciudadano.
Okay? The Hebrew word there for every is kol.
La palabra hebrea para cada o todo es kol.
Meaning all people.
Que significa todo, toda gente.
So that means Jew and Gentile.
Significa judío y gentil.
Okay? Citizen.
Ciudadano.
Etzrach.
Es Ezrach.
It means native.
Significa nativo.
Native of that soil.
Nativo de esa tierra.
Okay? Why are you living in a sukkah?
¿Por qué está viviendo en un sukkah?
Why is God reminding us every year?
¿Por qué Dios nos está acordando cada año?
To remember where you came from.
Para que te acuerdes de dónde viniste.
It's God's holy days.
Son los días santos de Dios.
Are reminders.
Son acordatorios.
Because he knows we're idiots.
Porque sabe que somos idiotas.
He knows we forget.
Él sabe que nos olvidamos.
He called us sheep.
Nos llamó ovejas.
That was not a compliment.
Eso no fue un complemento.
If he were to call you dolphins, that would have been a compliment.
Si te hubiera llamado delfín, eso sería un complemento.
If he would have called you a monkey, that would have been a compliment.
Si te hubiera llamado mono, eso sería complemento.
He called us sheep.
Nos llamó ovejas.
That was not a compliment.
Eso no fue un complemento.
Okay, so we got every citizen.
So tenemos cada ciudadano.
Now we go on to the next one.
Ahora vamos a la próxima página.
There you see the Hebrew.
Ahí ves el hebreo.
Be Israel.
Be Israel.
Okay. The when you see the prefix bet or a vet.
Cuando ves el prefijo bet o vet.
It's a conjunctive. It's a vav.
Es un vav.
Okay. Or a bet.
O un bet.
Meaning in.
Significa en.
Or on.
O en. En sí.
Like.
Como.
Okay. Be Israel means in Israel.
Be Israel significa en Israel.
So kol eretz, kol.
Kol.
Etzrach.
Etzrach.
Be Israel.
Be Israel.
That's what it says in the Hebrew.
Eso es lo que dice en el hebreo.
Kol Etzrach be Israel.
Kol Etzrach be Israel.
Every citizen of Israel.
Cada ciudadano de Israel.
Are you a citizen of Israel?
Eres ciudadano de Israel, sí.
The church says we are Israel.
Dios dice somos Israel.
Well, you ain't doing the holy days. You ain't going to be Israel too much longer.
No está guardando los días santos. No va a ser Israel por mucho tiempo más.
Look at verse 42 and 43 again.
Vamos a ver versículos 42 y 43 nuevamente.
You're to live in Sukkot for 7 days. Every citizen of Israel is to live in a sukkah. So generation after generation of you will know that I made the people of Israel live in a sukkah when I brought them out of the land of Egypt. I am Yehovah your Elohim. Every citizen.
Cada ciudadano.
Every citizen.
Cada ciudadano.
But the people say that's only for the Jews.
Pero la gente dice que eso es solamente para los judíos.
Evidently not.
Evidentemente no.
The word of God does not lie.
La palabra de Dios no miente.
The word of God does not change.
La palabra de Dios no cambia.
So if you're not doing Sukkot on the right day,
si no estás guardando Sukkot en el día correcto,
then you're not going to be welcomed in the Father's house.
No va a ser bienvenido en la casa de
and when
padre.
He comes to inspect you,
y cuando él viene a inspeccionarte,
at that wedding,
en la boda,
and he says to you, Frankie,
y te dice,
where are your clothes?
¿Dónde está tu ropa?
My wife didn't wash them.
Mi esposa no lo lavó.
Blame her.
De échale la culpa a ella. It's the same thing Adam did.
It was a woman.
Era la mujer. Here we go all over again.
Next slide.
La próxima.
All right, we're going to stop there.
Vamos a parar ahí.
We're going to stop on this slide.
Vamos a parar aquí en esta página.
Next week, we're going to start going into what's in your hand. What's this palm?
La próxima semana vamos a tocar sobre qué está en tu mano. Es esta palma.
But something very interesting that we're going to look at.
Algo bien interesante que vamos a mirar.
Is what's in our hand the other days also.
Es que está en nuestras manos los otros días también.
When you start to look at that, you see something very interesting.
Cuando empiezas a mirar eso, vas a ver algo bien interesante.
Any questions inside Beth Goyim here in the building?
Hay preguntas aquí en el edificio de Beth Goyim.
Adriana?
I'm going to see in regards to the fruit. Like,
yes.
Like,
you mean like right? What's right there?
Yeah,
we are.
Which is the
Etrach.
Don't worry.
I mean,
I'm going to show you what's in your hand.
No te preocupes, yo te voy a mostrar lo que está en tu mano.
I don't know. Okay, good.
Yes, we will be doing it.
Vamos a tocar sobre.
It's just quarter after, and I don't want to start a new section because it's a long section.
Es una sección larga.
Rabbi?
Yes, go ahead, Evelyn. Narlene?
I want to say something to you.
That was beautiful.
Eso era bello.
Did you hear her?
Marlene, how are you? How is your beautiful daughter and your sons?
Great, great, great. How are you? I hear you're a granddad.
I am a grandpappy.
Yes. The Grays are coming in now?
Oh, the Grays are here. It's called Connor and Tristan.
that's so good.
And their wives.
Their wives. Oh my goodness!
Your wives?
No, it's all the kids, and we have a school now.
Yes, and I hear that you're just growing leaps and bounds, and you opened up a new church,
Yes, we have a congregation in Bogota, Colombia. They're on right now. Hola, buenas noches, mi hijos Bogota, Colombia. All righty, let us just close in prayer, and we can talk. I can give Evelyn a call.
Vamos a terminar con oración.
All right, thank you, Lord, for your blessings today. Thank you, Lord, for everything. Thank you, Lord, for this beautiful study. May we be rewarded the palms in our hands if we run the race and not waste time. Your name, Yeshua. Amen, 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 amen.
Shalom. This is Messianic Rabbi Andrew Dinnerman. I would personally like to thank you for tuning in to the Remnant's Call each and every week. You can listen to the full message on our website, bethgoyim.org. If you have drawn closer to the King of Kings, learned more about Him today, we are blessed. If you are blessed by these messages, please consider a donation to our ministry. You can go to our website, bethgoyim.org. That's bethgoyim.org. And click on the donate button. You do not have to have a PayPal account to donate. All you need is a debit card. Once again, thank you very much for listening to The Remnant's Call.
If you have not taken your first steps to be born again, just ask God's help. Remember, it's His loving grace that has come to find you. No one is worthy or able to reach God, but God can reach us, and He's reaching out to you now. Just open your heart and let Him in. His arms are open, and the blessing of salvation and eternal life are waiting for you. Don't let it wait any longer.
Shalom. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord lift His face and shine upon you. May the Lord be gracious unto you and give you His shalom.
Shalom. My name is Messianic Rabbi Andrew Dinnerman, and I invite you to come to visit our congregation. If you are in the tri-state area, come out and visit with us on Shabbat. We are a congregation of Jews and Gentiles living as one in the Messiah Yeshua. Bgmc is a place of true worship. The focus never wanders from the Hebraic roots of our faith. Beth Goyim is rooted in the Word of God from Bereshit through to the Book of Revelation. Messiah's strong words against man-made tradition are carefully recorded in Matthew 7. That is the reason we only follow the straight-up instructions found in Scripture. Truly, the way, the truth, and the life. If you're looking for a deeper walk with Adonai, come out for our Tuesday evening Bible study called Messianic Torah Time. Come, spend a day with us on any Shabbat. We start at 11 a.m. with the sound of the ancient Hebrew shofar. Next, we offer our King praise and worship in English, Hebrew, and Spanish. After worship, we review the headlines in the previous week's news from around the globe, especially news from the Holy Land, Israel. We don't just list the news headlines as current events, but we comb through the scriptures, searching for clues to understand what they mean, and then to help pinpoint prophetically our current position on Adonai's clock. After digesting all that modern information, we leave the world behind as we journey with our Adonai deep into His eternal word. Not with just one or two scriptures, but usually seven or more scriptures. The spiritual nourishment and the richness of His kingdom become accessible to the ones who share this special time and seek them out. The day does not end there. Because Shabbat is so special to Him, there is always so much more that our King desires to share. So instead of separating and leaving, we stay together as a family for potluck lunch and an afternoon study of our King's Word. We close this Shabbat together with the reading of the new week's parasha. That's the Torah portion. Even after those blessings, many of us just can't get enough. So the members bring prepared homemade foods to share while we all enjoy an uplifting movie together. If all that information is not quite enough, you can check out our website where you will find over 200 video teachings and biblical holy day studies. Under Messianic Torah Time, the Hebrew Roots button, you'll discover free studies on many, many different topics, including PowerPoint slide presentations. If Beth Goyim sounds like a place you'd love to visit, but you live outside the tri-state area, there is still a way to connect with us. We stream live on the internet on Tuesday, Thursday, and Shabbat. The website is www.bethgoyim.org. That's BETHGOYIM.org. Our phone number is 973-338-7800 or 978-2-YESHUA. That's 978, the number 2, Yeshua. Shalom.